Hey guys, what's up? I am Shitanshu from Dream Abroad, and today in this video I will be discussing two very important questions that most of the Canadian aspirants or the people who want to come to Canada after getting their PR would have in their mind. Number one, why is Canada not conducting the all program draws? I know you must have noticed it by now that in the last 1 month or 5 weeks, Canada hasn't conducted any all program draws. However, it has conducted the PNP and CEC draws, but not the all program draws. So why is it so? Secondly, about the immigration processing fees. So recently it was announced that the Canadian government would be increasing the processing fee by 50%. That is a huge amount. Why is it happening at this moment? Is it actually interrelated somehow? Is it actually related to the COVID-19 and what is going around the world? So is it actually somehow related to this? We will discuss in this video. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back. Alright, so let's discuss and let's start with the first point. Why is Canada not conducting the all program draws? So to give you a little background of this, the last all program draw was conducted on March 4th when the cutoff score was 471. And since then, there have been 4 express entry draws, but none of them was an all program draw. But what has happened in the past 4 draws is that the invitations have been issued to only those people who were actually either invited by any provinces, which means they were actually PNP candidates, and the other was that they had some work experience in Canada before, which means they were CEC applicants or Canada Experience Class candidates. So in the last 4 draws, Canada haven't issued invitations to all those people who didn't had PNP invitations or who didn't have the Canadian work experience. So why is it so? Is it somehow related to COVID-19? I am not very sure of that. No one can be 100% sure of that. So this is just my personal opinion, that it is somehow related to COVID-19. And again, I repeat that this is just my personal opinion. There hasn't been any official confirmation from IRCC until now. But yes, personally, I definitely believe that this has got something to do with the uncertainties involved due to the COVID-19 pandemic. No one was actually prepared for such tough situations what we see at the moment around us. No one was actually prepared, neither the people, nor the governments, nor the organizations. Governments were caught off guard when all of this pandemic and health crisis has occurred. As a very good example of that could be seen in the announcement that was made around 11th or 12th of March, that the Canadian government would be issuing permanent residencies to 341,000 people in 2020 and 351,000 people in 2021. This announcement was made just before Canada started locking down and the government started preparing people to work from home and started to close businesses apart from essential services. This was just announced before that, and suddenly after that all program draws are being paused. Now if we assume that COVID-19 is one of the reasons, the uncertainties that follow this pandemic is definitely the reason. Now, I made a video a couple of days back when I told you about the statistics about the jobs lost. More than 3 million people would be losing their jobs in the upcoming days, and 1 million have already lost it. So this was the staggering statistics that has come up lately. Now, after this pandemic is over, after the health crisis is over, it would be followed by the economic crisis, and the biggest challenge before the government would be that they need to provide jobs to all those people who have lost it. I'm sure they would not like to add too many people to that list. They would try to keep the list as short as possible. However, it would be in millions, whatever they do. So that could be one reason why the government is not actually conducting the all program draws, because they know that 6 months, 8 months down the line, those people would actually come down to Canada and that would increase their unemployment rate even further. Now you will say that government is still issuing invitations to 3,900 applicants every 2 weeks, combining the CEC and PNP applicants. The number of applicants comes out to be 3,900 every 2 weeks. So how are those CEC and PNP applicants are different from those who don't have the invite or who don't have the Canadian experience? So PNP applicants are those applicants who have been forwarded or who have been approved by the provincial governments. So obviously they can't refuse the provincial government's nominations, right? Now the CEC candidates are generally those who are already working here, who have got, you know, more than 1 year of Canadian experience. They apply through the Express Entry program to get the PR, so obviously they would be on the, you know, high priority of the Canadian government. Now the other reason might be documentation. When we get the invitation, we have to submit a lot of documents which would actually be necessary at the time of submission of our application. Gathering all those documents in all parts of the world might not be an easy task at this point of time. Mind it, when the invitations are issued, they're issued to people from around the world. Now, if you see the situations in countries like Iran, in countries like Italy, in countries like China, they are locked down, and you never know, you know, when the lockdown will be over. How have we heard that, you know, Chinese lockdown got over, but we're expecting the second wave of COVID-19, the third wave of COVID-19. So you never know when the governments might impose the lockdown once again. In that case, it would be an added effort to give more time to those people. They will be raising the web forms, and then, you know, there will be several follow-ups. So that could be another reason why they're avoiding these all program draws, and why they're giving, you know, invitations only to those people who have been either approved by the provinces or they are already working here and they have some work experience, some Canadian work experience. All right, I've already talked a lot about the first point. Now it's time to talk about the second point. So it's about the hike or the increase in the Canadian immigration processing fee, which was about 50%. Now this change was done after 18 years. Now was it also related to COVID-19? I think not, and it is definitely mentioned in the website. The major reason behind it is the subsidy that is being given to these applicants. So that is the reason why they are increasing the processing fee by 50%. Let's see the official website of Government of Canada and what they have to say about it. Okay, so this is the official website of Government of Canada, and on April 1st, they declared that there would be an amendment of certain fees. This had nothing to do with COVID-19, and they've declared here that the fee would be $825. Which was, I think, around $550 earlier. So this is an increase of 350% straight away. Here they have mentioned the reason. So they have mentioned here that there was a significant imbalance which was there between the cost of providing services to permanent resident applicants and the fees paid by them. And these regulations aim to reduce the subsidization burden on the taxpayer. This will be achieved through shifting more of the cost burden to the users who benefit the most from the service. And then here they have also mentioned about the money that they would be actually earning finally. And they have said very clearly here that increasing permanent resident fees will generate revenues that will be used to better offset the cost of immigration, thereby reducing the cost burden on Canadian taxpayers. Now they have mentioned this very clearly in their website that this was because of the subsidy that is being now taken off. But I believe that there might be one hidden reason. The Trudeau government, when it was actually trying to come to the power for the second time, they promised that they would be waiving off the Canadian citizenship fee. Now that might be one factor that they're increasing fee somewhere and they're decreasing fee somewhere else. So this is a very lucrative kind of an offer. If there's a family of three people, you could straight away save around $2,000, $2,000 Canadian dollars, if you want to apply for the Canadian citizenship of the complete family. So that might be another factor. Again, this is my personal opinion. This is not mentioned anywhere in the official website of Government of Canada. But yes, this might be another factor. So yes, the summary of the matter is that the first point, which was about the all program draws, Canada is not conducting those all program draws or may have paused these all program draws, might be for because of the COVID-19 pandemic. They haven't released any official statement until now, but it might be because of that. And the second point where the Canadian government has increased the processing fee is because of the subsidy and might be because of the citizenship fee that they would be waiving off in the future. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you agree with what I just say, please put your comment down in the comment section below. I love to hear your feedback. I might not be able to reply to all of you, but I definitely check out all the comments which are there in the comment section. I love your comments. Thank you for the appreciation and the motivation that you regularly do. Stay safe, stay home, stay healthy. And if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, you know the deal. You have to click the subscribe button and that bell icon so that you can get all the notifications as well. Thanks again for watching this video.